Hello everyone, this is Siddesh Kumar, Utage, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today, we'll be discussing about the loop control structures, mainly the do-while loop control structures. In the last class or the last video lecture, we have discussed about the for loop and while loop. These both were the entry loop control structures. It means that the condition was checked before the statements were executed. So the learning outcomes after this video lecture will be the students will be able to develop programs using various loop control structure, that is the do while loop control structure. The following contents will be discussed in this particular video lecture: the do while loop, flowchart for the do while loop. The do while loop is similar to a while loop, except the fact that it is guaranteed to execute at least one time. It means the body of the loop or the statements will be executed once, and afterwards the condition is checked. Suppose I want to print some number, okay, the condition is not satisfied, it will print at least one time and afterwards the condition is checked. Do while loop checks its condition at the bottom of the loop. Flowchart for the do while loop. Start, that is the from where the execution of the program starts. Then the initialize phase. Initialize means you are giving the initial values. Then the body of the loop, it means the statements which are executed after the initialization. Okay, I want to have find the sum of even numbers or sum of numbers. Initial value will be I equal to 0. If I want from 1 to 10, it will be 1 will be the initial value. Body of loop means I want the sum of the numbers, sum is equal to sum plus I. So sum will be the initial value and I will be the value which will be incrementing body of. Okay, then afterwards it goes with the test condition. It means up to what iteration I should do it, whether I should do for the end condition, whether I want to do for the up to 10 iterations, I want to do up to 100. That is the test condition. So the test condition basically involves the relational operators: greater than, less than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, or it may be double equal to, that is the comparison operator. Then if the condition is true, suppose, then it will go again into the body of the loop and execute it till the condition is false. If the condition is false, it will execute the statement just below the what are the do while loop. Flowchart for the do while loop continues. Okay, start from where the execution of the program starts. Initialize, this is the point where we are giving some initial values for calculation purpose, like sum equal to 0, where sum is a variable which is initialized to 0 in order to calculate sum of series 1 to 10. Okay, I will be 1 and n will be the 10. In the body of loop, in this various statements are executed after fulfilling the condition. Test, here the condition is checked, that is the same using the relational operators. Okay, the four relational operators we are considering: greater than, lesser than, lesser than or equal to, greater than or equal to. Do while loop can be, or the general form of the do while loop can be written as follows: do, and that the statements to be executed after the condition, whatever the statement, sum, I want to find the sum of the numbers, I want to find the sum of the even numbers, sum of odd numbers, I want to check whether the number is a perfect number. Okay, so these are the conditions. I want to perform some operations. Body of the loop mainly consists of this type of statements. Then the while, that is a condition. So now just pause the video and think whether this do while loop or the for loop is a entry controlled or exit control loop control structure. The do while loop, I want to just go with an example calculating the sum of the odd numbers of the series 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11. I know the addition of the number is 36 if it is up to 11. Okay, so mainly it includes the hash include iostream.h. hash include, it means the preprocessor file, iostream.h, it means input output stream header file. It includes two defined objects or predefined objects called cout and cin. Cout is basically works as a for printing the displaying value. I want to display some value. Cin is for like scanf. It takes the input value from the user. Hash include conio.h. It includes again the two functions, that is getch and clrsr. Clrsr, it deletes the previous value. It omits or deletes the previous value, whatever the taken. And getch, it takes the whatever the value I have calculated, it will be displayed on the screen using the getch. Then the void main function. Void main function is nothing but void is the return type and main is from where the execution of the program starts. So with respect to this, integer n, it means n value will be up to what are the 11 value, okay. Sum equal to 0 is the initial sum. So, initial sum will be obviously 0 and I equal to 1 from where I am starting the loop. Cout enter n. The n value is the target value up to what I want to continue the program or up to what I want to execute the program. Cin n. N is the nothing 11. Do, it will come into the bracket. Now if I modulus of 2 not equal to 0, I want to check whether the number is an odd number or even number. So a number which is perfectly divisible by 2 is an even number. A number which is not exactly divisible by 2 is an odd number. So I modulus operator gives me the remainder. If the suppose the remainder obtained is not equal to 0, then it will be obviously an odd number. Then I'll come inside the loop, sum equal to sum plus I. I will calculate the sum, then I'll again increment it. I will check once again whether the number obtained is an even number or odd number. I will repeat up to I less than or equal to 11. Then I'll put the sum of the odd numbers. Getch. So let me explain about this program. Okay. First initial sum was 0 and I value was 1. 1 modulus of 2. 1 is not perfectly divisible by 2. It means it's true condition. The sum will be 1. Then I'll increment the I value to 2. Increment I plus plus, that is I plus plus is nothing but I equal to I plus 1. Initial sum was 1. Okay, whatever sum equal to sum plus I have done. But 2 is not an odd number. It's a false condition. 2 is perfectly divisible by 2. So the sum will be the again 1. Now I plus plus I'll do to 3. Now sum value will be again still 1. Okay. Now I is incremented to 3, then 3 is an odd number. It's not perfectly divisible by 2. Okay. So sum will be 1 plus 3 will be 4. Now I plus plus I have done 4. Now I value will be again 4, sum value will be 4. Now 4 is not perfectly divisible. 4 is perfectly divisible by 2. It means it's an even number. The sum will be 4 again, and the I plus plus I will do 5. Now sum value is 4, previous sum was 4, and 5 is an odd number. Okay, 5 divided by 2, I say it's not completely divisible, I'll get some 2.5. okay, but 5 divided by 2, if I get, I'll get a remainder as 1. Okay, then it's a true condition. So 9 plus, so 5 plus 4 will be the 9. Then I go to the 6. Okay, so 6 is a even number, so again the sum will be the same thing, 9. Now 7 is an odd number, it's a true condition, again the same thing. So odd number means it will get added. Okay, now it is going to get incremented to 8. The previous sum was 16. Now 16 plus whatever the 8 is nothing but the even number, false. So 16 again sum will be the same thing. For 9 it is an odd number, it's a true condition. 16 plus 9, 25. Now 10, again 10 is an even number, false condition. So afterwards sum will be the 25. Okay, 11 is an odd number, true condition. So it will be 25 plus 11 will be 36. So this is up to conditions. Okay, so these are the following references: object-oriented programming with C++ by E. Balgurusamy. Thank you.